Well, particularly wolves, the historical reference to them. You got Peter and the wolf and the three little pigs and the wolf and Little Red Riding Hood and the wolf. The wolf is always the villain in these stories. And that affects the way people feel about an animal.
At the Tallahassee Museum, you can travel to a bygone era of Florida history. Part of that bygone era is a misunderstood animal that was hunted out of our area.
Red wolves were once found in the southeastern United States. They ranged all the way from Texas down into Florida, up the coast to Virginia, and over to Pennsylvania. So they had a huge range. When the European settlers came, they decided that large predators, they didn't want to have them around. They considered them a threat to the children and livestock and that kind of thing. So we were very hard on the red wolves. And in the early 70s, a federal biologist named Curtis Carley realized that the red wolves had disappeared and they were nearly extinct.
The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service captured as many wolves as they could find, about 30 or so. These would be the future of the red wolf species.
And they selected 14 that they felt like were good founder animals and started to reproduce them in captivity. So they started talking with zoos to see about, you know, putting breeding pairs out in different places around the country. And we really thought it was a good fit for us because the red wolf was native to this area. The focus of the Tallahassee Museum is the Big Bend region of Florida. Since we're focused on the panhandle of Florida, that's the wildlife that we exhibit. We exhibit native North Florida animals. So any animal that lived here could be considered an animal that we could display. We have two pairs of wolves right now. We have a male and a female that are siblings, and the male happens to be cryptorchid, so he's sterile anyhow. And we have them off exhibit. And we have a pair of wolves that have mated now. We picked up a female that came from North Carolina about 3 months ago, I guess. And we have had a number of wolves here over the years. We've had three litters born here. We hope we're gonna have a litter this year. We're pretty sure that we got bred this year.
In addition to keeping them healthy and fed, the Tallahassee Museum wants to make sure their red wolves aren't bored.
If an animal's just sitting in the same space day after day, they explore it and there's nothing really new to see in there. So we try to present them with items that they'll interact with, items that cause them to use their natural abilities. It's called environmental enrichment. Sometimes we use spray. You can buy raccoon urine or a different type of fox urine. This stump behind me, this log, is a good example of environmental enrichment. We're going to put this in the habitat with the red wolves. It's a big log and it's hollow. You could probably put 3 or 4 people in there easily. So we anticipate that the wolves are going to be enjoying this because they naturally go into dens and things.
So why is so much effort spent on an animal that some consider a nuisance? For one, it's an ecologically important species.
They are an apex predator, and they prefer white-tailed deer if they can catch them. And that's the reason we have so many white-tailed deer now, because we've eliminated the natural predators. We took away their natural chicks. So that's a big function of the predators, is to keep populations in balance. When you start taking out a whole species of animals, it's going to leave a void, and whatever niche they fill is not going to be occupied. If the red wolf disappeared, the human race would continue on. It's kind of a philosophical question, you know. Do you feel enriched because we have black bears and animals living here in the wild? Or does it not make any difference to you at all? You know, some people could care less whether these wildlife existed. But I think complete people, they're aware that we aren't the only thing living here and that everybody needs to have the space and the ability to make a living.
For the Red Wolf, the Tallahassee Museum is one of those spaces. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.